Hello everyone, we are Team Elysium from Batch 16, Faculty of Information Technology. So we done our final year research on mechanism for checking and evaluating single essays of grade 5 students. In Sri Lanka, grade 5 scholarship exam is very competitive one, and the single essay question is very important one and mandatory one. In here, every candidate done common mistakes like spelling errors, grammatical errors, repetition errors like that. But students haven't proper and accurate mechanism to identify their mistakes and moving their single essay writing skills by themselves. Next, we move to our aim and objectives. The aim of this project is to implement the self-learning web-based system to indicate the spelling errors, grammatical errors, and topic relativity errors in an essay on grade 5 students. So these are our objectives. This is the others work related with our projects. And next, this is our approach. So in here mainly include three modules in our project: spelling error detection and correction module, grammar error detection and correction module, topic relativity checking module, and finally mark allocation module. So our first module is spell error detection and correction module. This is the flowchart of the module, and next explain the detailed design of the spell error detection and correction module. In the system, input is user input essay. In pre-processing module, tokenize that input sentence to word. In here, we used corpus file, and then in identify the spell correct incorrectness using corpus file. In here, assume all the words are available in the corpus file are correct. And if the user input word is available in a particular corpus file, then that word will be identified as a correct word. So in here, we introduce four approaches to detect the correctly spelled words, including three novel approach. At the beginning, without editing user input word, we try to identify the user input word is correct or not. If unable to find like that way, then use the object word checker method to identify the spelled correct and incorrect separately. If that also not possible, then move to the suffixes checker methods to identify the correct and incorrectness of the word. And the final correct word identification way is similar word checker method. Using the above three ways, unable to identify the correct word as the user input word, then come to that similar word checker method to identify that word correct or incorrect. So using that above mentioned four ways, if unable to identify the user input word as correct word, then that word will be identified as an incorrect word by the system. Then that word will pass to suggestion generation module to generate best suggestion for incorrectly spelled word. In here also, we used four ways to generate accurate suggestion for incorrectly spelled word. First one is using common error database, try to generate best suggestion for incorrectly spelled word. That is novelty approach in suggestion generation module. Second way is missing modifier identification. If unable to generate suggestion for using that way, then go to third method, permutation generation module. That also not possible to identify best suggestion for the incorrect word. Then go to final suggestion generation method, edit distance module. So using that four ways, try to generate best suggestion for incorrectly spelled word by the user. And after that, find the correct suggestion word for the incorrectly spelled word and replace it by the system. And then that word pass to grammar checking module. And also correctly spelled word and incorrectly spelled word identified separately. And according to that, generate spelling error marks and display that to user. So that is the implementation details related with the spell checking module. Then moving forward, those are the result related with the spell error detection and correction module that is based on precision recall and F measure values. So that is the overall evaluation summary. And this is the conclusion and future works related with the spelling error detection and correction module. So that is the process of spell error correction and detection module. So then continue with the grammar checking module. Uresha will continue.
Thank you, Prarthana. Second main module is grammar error detection and correction module. Moving to implementation, here input is spell correct for stack sentences, pre-processing, grammar error detection, error type identification, provide suggestions for grammatically incorrect sentences, and allocate final grammar module marks are able to identify as the process-related activities here. Moving to high-level flowchart, you can see grammar error detection has implemented with set of rules matching with database. The grammar suggestion module used both database and corpus here. Next, you can see this is the detail flow of grammar module, and this is an example for grammar error detection generated output. Moving to error type identification, there are four error types able to identify as subject-verb mismatch error, preposition error, assembler kriya error, and tense error. These are the examples for system-generated output from grammar suggestion module. Moving to evaluation, you can see in this proposed system, when you see sentences with words belong to the corpus and within the defined scope of the grammar detection, accuracy is 100 and error type identification accuracy is 93% and suggestion module accuracy is 83%. This is the considerable accuracy when compared with other projects. Moving to conclusion, Singhala has a lot of grammar rules and it is very complex. A rule-based approach has used to implement this module. The proposed grammar module was able to cover free word order problem within the scope successfully. Complex grammar rules and novelties like indeterminate, gavravartha, nithyabahuvachana, samuhavachi pada, preposition categories, and asambhava kriya identified here. This grammar checker has only covered present tense and past tense as tense wise, singular and plural as number wise, masculine and feminine as gender wise, first person, second person, and third person as person wise, and active voice sentences. In future, supposed to conduct grammar checking for passive voice sentences as free word order problem more widely. The accuracy of rule-based approach is able to further increase by defining more grammar rules and increasing word count at the corpus. Then instead of using a rule-based approach, move to a hybrid approach also another direction. Not only that, able to widely address error types and suggestions for the both subject and verb directions here, able to identify as also a future work. Next, Ishanka will explain topic relativity module.
Thank you, Uresha. Topic relativity checking module is checked under several criteria, and this part is the main part which affects the final mark of the essay which is written by the student. In here, content of the essay is mainly checked within the database. And in here, these are the major categories which we are going to be checked. The sentence similarity, that means word similarity checking, sentence similarity checking. And under those criteria, again, corpus-based, web-based, positive quality and negative quality, similarity checking is going here. Moving forward, this is the main process of the module. As you can see, the input for this module is the grammatically checked and spell-checked sentence. And within the module, the word is going to be checked, and how the word is related to the given topic is going to be checked. In here, also, similarity of the word is going to be checked with the main criteria, which is called TF-IDF module calculation. And sentence similarity is going to be checked with the negative quality sentences and positive quality sentences. And output of this module is the finalized essay mark. Moving forward, this is the module flow of the relativity checking module. And going to the next slide, this is the detailed diagram of the relativity checking module. In here, you can see the relativity checking module is mainly flowing under six main criteria. And again, next slide. In here, you can see the implementation details. Mainly, this is the word similarity. And again, the case word checking is here. In the case word checking, mainly the words as ahasa, abraya, sulanga, the words like that are detected mainly after the written sentences are checked. And in here, student may be written as the words words like ahase, raye, sulangata. In here, the cases are removed and the exact noun root word is detected here. Moving forward. In here, as you can see, the similar words are checked here. The student may be written the words as sayura, guana, like that. So within the system, it's going to be detected the sayura is related to the word sagare, and same mark is allocated for the words like that. Moving forward, In here, the special term frequency and inverse document frequency mechanism is used here to find out the main descriptive words, and the most important words are calculated here. So in here, the weight of the word is calculated and given the percentage of similarity mark in the within the module. In the next slide, you can see the web content similarity checking. In here, the similarity of the content is going to be checked with the website articles, and the links of the website articles are inserted within the system. And in here also, a considerable percentage of the output mark is given here. Going forward, you can see the sentence similarity checking is again done based on the polarity, and the sentences are going to be checked with the negative polarity and the positive polarity. The sentences with the ending with no or no plus verb are going to be checked as negative polarity sentences, and other sentences are considered as the positive polarity sentences. Next slide, you can see the main criteria which I have mentioned earlier are presented here. And again, going forward, you can see the finalized output of the system, and here the output mark is given out of the 6, and you can see the all the marks are considered here as the under the marking criteria. So going forward, this is the conclusion and further work of this module, and yes, thank you.